So, what's next for the MacBook Air? Well, today we have a new leak on a massive graphics boost report, with the M2 chipset getting more cores in its graphics card or GPU. We have all the details on this and also the latest on the new MacBook Air release date and price, and of course a summary on the design and specs as well. Hi, it's Matt here. So new M1X Macs are expected this fall. But what about Macs that will get the new M2 chipset inside, and what will they be capable of? Well, it's been over 10 months since we had an update to the MacBook Air. The biggest change we saw in that last model was the new Apple Silicon M1 chipset put inside, and also the cooling fan being removed from the model. But with leaks and rumours dropping in for the new MacBook Air, I have decided for all the new MacBook videos like this one going forward, I'm going to give you the latest details on specific models, then details of the planned release date time, then a summary of the MacBook starting prices and features that we have learnt in previous leaks. After, I'm going to reveal my wish list for the next MacBook Air. Also, put in the comments below of what features you'd like to see in the next MacBook Air, and in my next video, I may feature your comment and discuss my thoughts around it. So then, let's start with the news of the M2 chipset. So a new report from a leaker called Dylan, who has got many previous MacBook leaks correct in the past years, has reported that the new MacBook Air is likely to be one of the debut devices, so in other words, one of the first devices to feature the new M2 chipset, what is the successor to the M1. This is not the successor to the M1X, as the architecture of this chip is very different to M1 and the upcoming M2. Dylan has even shared this: "Just wanted to share some details on when to expect the next generation M2, not the M1X, which is reserved for the Pro Mac devices. The processor is on track to release on the first half of 2022 alongside the upcoming colourful MacBook Air. At the moment, it's looking like the CPU will retain the current 8 cores, but the GPU that powers the graphics is going to be topped up from 8 cores to 10 cores from this report we have had from Mark Gurman. Bolting on 2 more cores means that the MacBook Air will have even more potential in undergoing heavy graphics tasks like rendering, and even some more gaming potential than what we get with the M1 right now. So, like a few of my other videos, just a quick note here. With any of these leaks, even up to the new MacBook Air's release date that I find and show you guys, a lot of previous leaks for other Apple products have come true, but there are sometimes some that get misinterpreted based on the facts that leakers have been told. I can only present to you what I have been told and shown. No leak or rumour is 100% true until we see the final MacBook Air being officially shown from Apple. However, if you are like me and if you are watching this video, then you're as curious as I am in knowing what the next generation MacBook Air is going to be like, and want to know what the latest leaks and rumours are, no matter what they tell us. So with that out of the way, let's talk about the release date next, and then a summary of everything we know with the prices included as well. So just quickly, this channel has just hit over 230,000 subscribers, which is absolutely amazing, and we did a giveaway of a MacBook Pro M1. Well, I've got you some great news, guys. We're doing another giveaway, and it is for this. It is for an iPad Pro M1 with 8 GB of RAM and 256 GB of storage. Now, anybody can enter in to win this giveaway around the world. It is an international giveaway. But all I want to know from you guys is basically, what Apple tech are you planning to buy in 2021? What other tech are you planning to buy if it's not going to be Apple tech? Write it down in the comments below, and make sure at the same time as well to subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because when we get over 260,000 subscribers, I'm going to be revealing who the winner is of this iPad Pro. So make sure you do that right now, because you'll want to know if you're going to be the lucky person to get your hands on this iPad Pro. Also at the same time as well, if you're enjoying this video so far, please make sure to press the like button. Well, let's get back to the video. So release day, I'm going to make a more dedicated video on the leaks we have heard about it. However, in short, originally we thought until WWDC this year, we could be getting the M2 MacBook Air in 2021, in October or November time. But with these leaks and rumours from Mark Gurman, Ming-Chi Kuo, you can see here with the mini LED, you can see everything is more pointing towards a 2022 release instead. A few other leakers have pointed at early 2022 as well, but there are still quite a few who are standing their ground with late 2021. But I think with WWDC and now with the delay of the new 14 and 16 inch MacBook Pros, that leakers are saying that an M1X is still going to be put inside them. So I believe based on these facts, it is likely that the early 2022 date is on the cards for a release with the new MacBook Air. So going forward, I'm going to be saying 2022 as the release date. But when in 2022, you might ask? Well, as some of the leaks have said in this video, it's going to be early 2022. If Apple's track records of events and announcements is anything to base time on, based on these leaks, I believe we'll be getting an Apple event in mid-March or April time in 2022, so the release date will be soon after, either in April or May time next year. But moving on, let's do a summary of what the 2022 MacBook Air is going to give us and also the prices. So what we've heard from the MacBook Air M2 or the new model that's coming out in 2022, it will be a 13.3 XDR Liquid Retina Mini LED display. Now it's likely this 13.3 inch display is going to be retained and not upgraded to a 14 inch just yet. The main reason is, even with the new MacBook Pro 14 inch coming out, it is likely Apple are going to still continue to sell the MacBook Pro M1 what has a 13.3 inch display as well, so I'm sure the MacBook Air will also be retaining its same size screen. But the resolution of that screen will be the same of what we get on the MacBook Air right now, what will be a 1680 by a 1050, and it will also be a Pro Motion display for the first time, what will be a 120Hz refresh rate built into that display, so very similar to the 12.9 inch iPad Pro that we have right now. For storage, it is likely it's going to be very similar to what we have right now, so 256GB, 512, 1TB and 2TB storage options. There will be that brand new M2 chipset inside it, and it is likely, according to the latest leaks, what I will cover more in other videos, to be an 8-core CPU and also a 10-core GPU at the moment. There will also be the option again of 8GB or 16GB of RAM to pick for your MacBook Air. The actual design is going to be a completely new design, as you can see here. It's likely it's going to be a little bit more thinner than the MacBook Air we have right now, but we're also going to be getting colours as a first, according to some of the latest leaks and rumours. But it will be made out of aluminium, and there will still be two USB-C Thunderbolt 4 ports on one side, and also those Thunderbolt 4 ports will be also compatible with USB 4. The new design, what I just spoke about, the new colours ranges that are coming out for it will be blue, green, red, silver, yellow, orange and purple, what are the exact same colours that we got with the iMac M1. It's also likely we've been told that there's going to be a center stage webcam in the middle of the new MacBook Air, what will be a 12 megapixel camera. Battery life is going to be the same what we're getting right now, so up to 18 hours if you use it well. And then prices wise, it looks likely that it's going to be very similar to what we have right now, with 256GB starting at $999, 512GB at $1,249, 1TB at $1,499, and 2TB at $1,849. Now obviously all these specs that I've just shown you here are based on what we know at the moment. This could change in the future. But next, for my wishes for the MacBook Air. My wish is to do with the colours. So we've seen some great colours in the concepts and renders that you're looking at right here. But also there are some rumours and leaks to say that the new MacBook Air is going to have all these multiple different colours that are going to be very similar to the iMac and the iPad Air, for example. However, I would like to still have the ability to buy a silver, a gold, or a space grey MacBook Air like we can right now. But those are my thoughts and my current wish for the MacBook Air. However, let me know your thoughts if you agree with having this kind of choice or not. Also, at the same time, write in the comments what your wishes would be for the new MacBook Air in 2022. Well guys, it's time to wrap up this video, so if you have enjoyed watching it, please make sure to like the video, and at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews and comparisons, please make sure to hit the subscribe button followed by the notification bell. Until next time guys, I'll see you soon. Bye.